الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. It's an obligation upon Ahl al-Sunnah to help one another, and for Ahl al-Sunnah to support one another, and for Ahl al-Sunnah to love one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all throughout the Qur'an has made clear for us the akhwa and the brotherhood. Innama al-mu'minun ikhwa. Verily the believers are brothers to one another. And if you don't have the ability to help your brothers and sisters in faith, then at least supplicate for them. Supplicate for the sake of Allah subhanahu to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for your brothers and sisters. And as was narrated on Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, "Inna da'wat al-akh fillah tustajab." That verily the supplication for your brother, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your brother in the your brother in faith is accepted. And what we learn from this are many benefits. This shows us the importance of the hirs al-Islam ala taqwiyat al-ruwabit al-akhawiyah bayn al-muslimin fi jami' al-ahwal wa azman. This shows us the importance of the Islamic brotherhood and that relationship between brothers and sisters in faith for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during all times and in all situations. It also shows us the benefit of supplicating for your brothers for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they're not present, your brothers and your sisters in Islam. And also we learn from this is that the supplication of the person who is supplicating for someone else who is not present, supplicating for their brother or sister in faith who's not present, is accepted immediately by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help and aid our brothers and sisters of Ahl al-Sunnah from everywhere and help the Muslimin in general to come back to their religion and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala correctly. And we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to help our brothers and sisters in Damaj, in Yemen, in the village of Damaj, this place of great learning and this center of learning, this Markaz al-Sunnah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve it and protect it and protect the people, protect every single individual there who's studying for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those people who assist them with their wealth and property and time. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them from the evil of Ahl al-Tashayyur, those people who make takfir of the Sahaba, those people who speak about Ummana Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha and accuse her of adultery, those people who make it a pillar of their faith to hate the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless Ahl al-Sunnah with victory wherever they may be struggling over the people of kufr, wa shirk, wa zandaka, and bid'ah mukafara, and any other kind of deviance, and any kind of opposition to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless us, and bless the Muslimin fi kulli makan, and raise up the Muslimin fi kulli makan, and bless us to practice our religion in a manner that pleases Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless our brothers and sisters in Damaj, in Yemen, and help them in every aspect of their affairs and bless them to have peace and stability and to have victory over those people who are trying to cause them harm. And may Allah destroy those people who hate His religion, who fight His religion, who oppose His religion. And may Allah tabarak ta'ala raise us up and protect us from kulli su wa makruh. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.